we start from considering two well-known indicators of the phenomenon of so-called big data. First of all, in every year and a half, the amount of data that is exchanged in the internet doubles. And in 2020, for every human being, there will be available about 1,000 sensors. So starting from these two indicators, it is clear that several disciplines have arisen that investigate big data, such as Internet of Things, cloud computing, mobile computing, and so on and so forth. Ricominciamo? Oppure adesso posso continuare? But when about 200 years ago, statistics at the end of the 18th century started to produce methodologies, models, and techniques, the situation was very different, in the sense that statisticians had, in some cases, very few data to represent the phenomenon, and from the other side, when they had a lot of data, they were compelled to use a sample of data, since they did not have available technological infrastructures to analyze them. Now, as I said at the beginning, we have available a lot of data. Unfortunately, this lot of data has a data life cycle that is very different from the traditional one in traditional information systems. In the sense that, first of all, we have to select which are the data sets that are useful for our analysis. Second, data are very heterogeneous. Think to data that are captured from the Internet of Things, or from sensors, and from the other side, other data that are captured from social networks. They are quite different in comparison. And from the other side, data are dirty. Data are dirty. So, at the beginning of the life cycle of data analysis, it is extremely relevant to perform at least two phases in the data life cycle. From one side, data have to be assessed from the point of view of their quality, and the quality has to be improved in such a way that the analysis also, the effectiveness of the analysis is improved. And from the other side, since data are divided, splitted in an enormous amount of different data sets, data have to be integrated. There is a figure that says that the 80% of time in the analysis life cycle is spent on the management of data, and the 20% of time is spent in the concretely in the analysis. And so you can understand why several research disciplines have arisen. First of all, data quality management, from the other side, data integration, and so. Such disciplines exploit another important instrument in management of data, that are so-called ontologies or semantic models. Intuitively, if we have a viable semantic model, then the activity of putting together data that have been captured from heterogeneous sources, it's easier and it's more effective. And the same for data quality assessment and improvement. Now, moving to data analysis, which are the goal of data analysis? The goal is typically to produce a decision model, or else an interpretative model of a phenomenon, or else a predictive model for the future, or a prescriptive model. So, all of these models, in a sense, can be adopted, are useful in a lot of different disciplines, in from genomics to social sciences to medicine to the analysis of spatial data, and so on and so forth. And in all these disciplines, in order to produce a model of the types that I have listed before, you have to analyze data. But what does it mean to analyze data? formerly, 200 years ago, 100 years ago, the statisticians have proposed a model that is based on correlation of data. A model that produces a function that explains the result of the adoption, a model that relates input data to output data, and that is typically produced by means of an activity that is called correlation. But as we have seen, several universes, several data sets are extremely heterogeneous and so are in a sense chaotic, represent the phenomenon but in a way that is chaotic. So other models have been investigated that on the contrary adopt a learning paradigm. So you assume you have at disposal some data in which the relationship between input and output is known, and at that point you perform a training on this data and adopt that model that you have created in order to produce an interpretative model, a predictive model for the whole set of data. And also in this activity, intuitively you may understand that having data whose semantics is well known and is well expressed allows to produce an interpretative model, an interpretative model, a predictive model that is more effective and that has more quality than the case in which you start from completely heterogeneous and weak semantic data sets.